patient. I'm a doctor, not a bricklayer.
How's it, guys? Well, I'm going to be starting a new model kit today. Well, maybe not today, maybe tomorrow. But anyway, this is just going to be a quick show of the model. This is a group build which I'm starting. It's been hosted by Greg Reilly's. And the group build is called Heroes of the Hour. I can't think of the channel where I saw it on now. I think it was All Wood Modeling Mayhem. I think it was his channel I saw it on. It started the beginning of this month. I'm already 2 weeks late for it, but at least there's no end date, so that doesn't matter. The last video I mentioned it, but I couldn't remember what it was, the name. I had to go look it up. So anyway, I'm going to be building a rather huge model for this. It is a medical model, but it's not designed as a medical model. I'm going to be changing it into what she was when she served in the Navy. So by saying Navy, a lot of you people must probably go, but what was in the Navy that could result in medical stuff? I'll be showing you that in a second, and then we'll be talking about it. So give me a second, I'll quickly move over there where the box is lined, and I can show you what I'm going to be doing, telling you what her name is and taking it from there. It's going to be a rather huge build because a lot of the stuff I have to change, and there's still stuff I have to find, but we'll talk about that in a second. Be back now. Whew. Well, there we go, guys. This is the RMS Titanic model kit. This is a museum quality model kit, as they call it. The reason why is because your railings that go on the front of the ship here, they are photo etched parts. But now some of you are going to say, but what's the Titanic got to do with any medical stuff? Well, there were three ships: Olympic, Titanic, and what would have been called the Gigantic. But when little old Titanic here hit an iceberg and sank, they changed her name to Britannica, or Britannic. I can never pronounce that ship's name right. During her construction, when the Titanic sank, they double hold her, but by the time she got outfitted and almost ready to start serving, a little old thing called World War I broke out. So she was enlisted into the Navy as a hospital ship, there for the medical part. She served in World War I as the HMHS Britannic. Now, HMHS, if anybody doesn't know, stands for Her Majesty or His Majesty's Hospital Ship. So I'm going to be doing this particular model kit up as the hospital ship Britannic. And I've got another kit that's very similar to this. I think it's the same model, just different packaging, different age. I'm going to build that one up as Titanic. Then I've got another ship like this, which was damaged, when my uncle knocked a heater over onto it many years ago. I want to strip that one if I can, and that I will ship. I want to repair and rebuild as the Olympic. All three ships will be 1-2-3-50 scale, so they'll go nicely together. But this particular one, I'm going to be building up as the hospital ship, Britannic. I hope you guys enjoy it. Anyway, this video is just the unboxing part of it, so we still got to get to that before we actually can start building. Give me a second while I quickly pop the lid off the box. And we can start looking at what's inside. Okay. First things I'm going to show you are the original decals that come with it. As you can see, this one says Titanic. Comes with yellow lines that go around the ship. None of this I'm going to use. And you can see this paper is pretty yellowed already. It's a pretty old kit. If I can find a date, I will bring it to show you guys. But this just shows you where to put all the photo edge that comes with it. Of course, on the Britannic, this piece here will be extended and that piece won't be used, so you'll need more of that going along the edge here. So there's quite a bit of changes that I have to do. From there, we'll go quickly to the instructions. The instructions aren't too bad looking. They are still nicely done. Yeah, it says 1989 and 1999, but I don't think that's when the model kit was built. And it's basic, shows you all the tree parts over there. I can get it nicely open. It shows you all the different tree parts. And then how to slowly build up the ship. I'm not going to go through all the pages, because there is a lot of pages. There is 32 pages in total. So yeah, this is of course the instruction manual, and there it shows you all that. But we won't be building her up as Titanic. There's the photo etch. Unfortunately, it doesn't come with ladders and all the stuff I would have liked. That's a bit disappointing. And there's the first tree. There's the back of the ship. That is the poop deck. Indeed, the flash on the part is very minimal. I don't really see much flash, just a little bit of nonsense here and there, but otherwise very clean. I believe this is the kit I bought in New York when we were on holiday. I got it cheaper than what I could get it if I ordered it on eBay. Then I do have another kit which I did buy on eBay, which is exactly the same kit, it's just the box is slightly different. Then you get a postcard, which is quite nice, James Cameron's Titanic. There are the clear parts with some flags. There is a part of the base, Titanic. There are the propellers and the anchors. There are the smokestacks. Finally, for all the dicks. And there I go, drop it. There are more dicks. Some of, I believe that will be a deck. The side walls of the ship and then the decks themselves. There is the base. There's some anchor chain and some rope. And then finally, the hull of the Titanic. Now, if I'm going to light this, there is a lot of holes to be drilled out. The only problems I do see on these models, for some reason, is right over there. I don't know how nicely you can see that indentation, but that is where one of the pegs are. And it's got that indentation on both sides of the ship, so that would have to be filled and made nice and smooth. And there's the other one. And then of course there's quite a bit of smoothing off to do at the bottom, because it's as if the two halves weren't lined up properly when they molded it. And you've got this huge piece of plastic sticking up at the bottom, which makes it feel like it's not lined up properly. So all that has to be smoothed out first. But yeah, that is going to be the Britannic when she is finished. This is going to be a huge build, because a lot of stuff I have to scratch build. Like up in this area here, there are two huge cranes that go up, and then there's, I think, two on each side at the back. So it's 2, 4, 6, 8. I think I've got 10 cranes to build, scratch build, that go to go up there, and then figure out how the, well, that's got to go in the back of the ship, how it's supposed to look. So guys, that's going to be my entry into the Heroes of the Hour group build. There's the Britannic. So hopefully this all turns out well and the model turns out beautiful. The whole ship of course becomes white. All the whole line from the red all the way to the top is white. Then along the edge here, it's got a big green line with your hospital crosses. And then at the top here, it's got the hospital cross. So anyway, guys, that's it for now. I'll see you in a second. Okay, guys, that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll be starting to build the actual ship. It's going to be a tough and long build. I'm not sure how long this is going to take me, because now I'm back at work, so I don't have much time. And weekends are a bit of a pain, because I've got to do garden work and stuff. I'm not sure when our garden boy will be back, because of the lockdown. I'm not sure when he'll start work again, because he normally works on a Monday, but he hasn't been to work for the last 2 weeks since I started work. He hasn't come. Anyway, enough of him. I hope you guys are going to enjoy this build. And if you're not doing a group build and you got something running around that's a fire brigade, whatever, come on, join along with us. It'll be fun to see you building something maybe that you normally wouldn't build. If you can, get hold of yourself an ambulance or a fire truck or something and have some fun. Anyway, guys, until the next video, we will be starting to build the third out of the three sisters, out of the Olympic class ocean liners. Have fun with whatever you're doing. Live long and prosperous. Stay safe. And have fun with whatever you're building. Cheers.